lots of high-tech Texan.
The world has waited almost a quarter century for the new Ford Bronco to be released. May I present the 2021 Ford Bronco Outer Banks. Now you'd think my review, like many of my ilk, would start out with something like, "Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to bury the Jeep Wrangler." Because clearly, this is exactly what Ford was going after with the Ford Bronco. Did they achieve what they were going after? Well, I'll tell you what, after 1 week driving around in this Bronco with more head turns than almost any other vehicle that I have tested in almost 15 years, it certainly is a stunner from the outside. But let's take a look on the inside. How does it ride? Is it worth the price? And bottom line, can you even find one at your dealerships? Let's hop in the 2021 Ford Bronco Outer Banks 4x4. All right, before we open the door to get inside, let's take a look at the outside, because when I talk about head turners, this is what I mean. Look at this. Have you ever seen a grill like that? Two big eyes staring right at you. Ford really went out for something different. Now, the first time I took a look at this, I'm thinking, you know what? It looks a little Land Roverish, when, you know, kind of the square back. But then again, look a little closer. Okay, yeah, you're going to go for a Jeep Wrangler, certainly a little longer than your typical Jeep Wrangler looks. But unmistakably, Ford said, hey, let's take a look at this. We are going to do something different with the Bronco, and that's just that mean, lean grill staring right at you. Without a doubt, you look in your rear view mirror and you see this thing behind you, you know exactly that this is going to be Bronco. Without a doubt, certainly distinctive. On the outside of this particular one, it's 4x4, you're going to get a 32-inch wheel. And the ride is very comfortable on these wheels. Now, the original version, let's just say the low-end base model, you're going to come with 30-inch tires, but these 32 give it a nice ride. The doors certainly can be taken off. I did not attempt to do that, mostly because it's kind of a pain and it takes a good 20 or 30 minutes. But if you look closely, Ford designed something pretty sleek. If you take the door off, look where they placed those rear view mirrors. They placed it right here on the actual, it's right in front of the windshield. And so once you take the doors off, these remain. The rear view mirrors remain. You don't need to replace them. So that's pretty smart engineering. Around the outside, you're going to get a really nice trim. I want you to notice also that these doors and the windows, when you open them, they are frameless. Now, what it does, it gives a little lighter feel, which is, you know, typically okay, because if you do ever take these side doors off, you can pretty much do it yourself without any help. But it also gives a little bit of a flimsy feeling every time you've kind of opened this thing. Other than that, not a big deal by not having those frames. On the back end, without a doubt, you've got that Ford Bronco bucking logo, which looks good. The typical, you know what, you know, Ford is notable for those, you know, typical kind of a C-shaped taillight, the kind of, let's just say, stylized them. Do like the fact that they even thought about this on that spare tire that goes on the back. If you look closely right here on that little spindle, there is that camera that gives you that rear view camera. So pretty smart designing that. Going around the back, opens up like a typical Jeep. And again, I have to compare this to the Jeep because this is the closest thing that they were going for. This is a four-door. It actually has pretty decent, I'm going to say decent cargo space. These are the two tops that I took off the front part. Comes with cases so you can keep them in there. Obviously, I was a little bit lazy when I was doing that. The second row does fold down, so it's going to give you some ample room. Back here, it comes with the mat. Underneath here, they have tie-downs, which kind of does not make sense because if I want those tie-downs, I'm going to have to flip this mat up. I think the mid-level refresh, or certainly version number two of this, they're going to kind of rethink that. In the back, obviously, a little LED. No doubt there's a ton of power, 12-volt USB-A's, USB-C's throughout as we take a look around. But all in all, it's nice and ample space. I do want to concentrate on the top, because what is the point of having a nice 4x4 rugged vehicle without having a roof? So these are hard panels in this particular model. And what I did is I was able, relatively easy with a few latches, to take this front panel off. Now, it comes in two parts. There's a left side and there's a right side. Now, interesting. Now, this is really, really kind of mind-boggling to me. This is the rear panel. The rear panel is really one big panel. But because in this version, and it's got these rails right on top, you cannot remove this back panel. I mean, I tried and tried and tried until I tried. I had to Google the thing. Unless you take these rear, these racks above off, you're not gonna be able to take that off. So pretty much I've been rolling around at least with the top off, but I could put those two panels back on within a matter of minutes and it's really good. So there is the quick outside look. Inside, well, we're gonna get into that, but in terms of the ride, it's got that V6, which is nice, a 2.7 EcoBoost. That's it, 2.7. Without a doubt, it's a lot of power with a 10-speed shifter. Yeah, could they had a 3.5 or something like that? It'd be nice, but you know what? We're gonna take this because it does give a lot of power to weight ratio oomph, and it's a very pretty, fast, zippy, you know you're getting from A to B where you wanna go with a lot of that power. Ah, like I promised, let's take a look inside now. Welcome to the inside of the Ford Bronco. Now I'm gonna do something a little different. I'm sitting in the passenger seat right now so we can get a bigger, easier view of what's going on here in the totally new, and you can't be redesigned because this is a new model, interior. Now the front seat over here, the first thing that you notice, the entire vehicle inside is built around, that's right, a 12-inch display. This is an infotainment with Ford Sync system, which has always been very, very good. This is a horizontal layout. Now, this is relatively the same system in the F-150 trucks. As you know, the F-150 trucks have a more vertical layout of the screen, but this actually works quite well. And believe me, you know I do a lot of technology. Large screen, better. Look at all the real estate they have. Technically, they could have gone longer, but you know what? This is first version. We're not going to yell at them. The screen itself, easy to use. Obviously, it is touchscreen, easy to set up your phones. Yes, it does have Android Auto. And oh, by the way, it also has Apple AirPlay too, easy to connect. It divides the screen into thirds. And so on the right third, always, you're gonna get a navigation. However, you can sit here and start flipping pages. So you can do a little functions like zone lighting and what have you. Here we've got the radio, the nav can go big screen. We've got a number of different apps that you connect to. And so easy to touch. What I do like also is the big primary things that we use this for, such as the volume. It's actually a knob, a go figure, all right, as well as the air conditioning. And I like this. I think Ford finally figured it out that the primary things that we need to do, quickly turn the radio up and down, and my goodness, it is hot here. These are actual hard dials, hard buttons, instead of anything digitally. I dig that whatsoever. The layout of the screen, quite nice. Yes, it's all, you know, non-digital. It's just, it is all digital instead of anything, including the tachometer, the speedometer. The steering wheel, nice, grippable. All the functions that you see on the screen do typical everything. You can control the radio. You control all the different functionality. But when it comes to putting the car between second and four-wheel drive, two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, look what we have here. We have a wheel. And I like that they put a wheel instead of a little flip switch or something. But the interesting thing over here, gotta go with marketing, they call this the GOAT. This is the GOAT mode shifter. That's right, maybe they're gonna go directly after Simone Biles, Tom Brady, maybe Michael Jordan to endorse this. Maybe not, because GOAT is an acronym for goes over almost any terrain. Ah, you see what they did there? Very easy to flip through anything in terms of mud, rocks, and hills. And it's also right here on the top of it, you can go from the four low to the four high and to the second gear also high. So it's right there at your fingertips. I like the fact, and then a number of people who actually popped into this vehicle, the first thing they notice are the, and I'm gonna call them chicken grips. There's three chicken grips, one right here on the passenger's left knee. There's also one for the driver and for the passenger on their right side so they can easily grip it too. But overall, it's very comfy. In terms of headroom, I mean, heck, I'm a 6 foot tall dude. Easily can get in not only the front, but also the back. And of course, the top roof goes straight up so you can see up. However, that back seat, it remains to be seen. Now, speaking of the back seat, a very strong back seat. That's right. Three people can fit back here. Even some of my 6 foot tall dudes were able to ride in here comfortably. It's got a nice headroom. And again, that roof isn't going anywhere because that's that back panel. Do you want to ride in here 1500 miles across the country? No, but if you want to play around for a weekend, maybe you go on a nice 100-mile trip, it's certainly going to be fine. Nice leg rooms in the back. We've got a USB-A, a USB-C. It would be nice to be able to control the air conditioning system back here. However, it comes from underneath the seats. So all in all, the inside, pretty passable to me. So there you go. A first look at the 2021 Ford Bronco. It's the Outback 4x4. Now, there's seven different flavors, if you will, of the new Ford Bronco, starting with the base model, which is listed at about $28,500, all the way up to that first edition, about $56,000. This is the Outer Banks model. It's gonna start right around $40,000. Good luck, because they've added the Lux package and a few more. This is gonna top out about $54,000. But again, this is just the MSRP. You know the situation right now in the world with the slowness and the slowdown of delivery of cars and trucks right now. Ford dealerships have reported to me, certainly anecdotally, that the fact is they are waiting. There is a list to wait, and good luck even negotiating, because you may pay that MSRP, if not even more. Should you get this thing? I'll tell you what, yeah, it's a different opportunity, a different option to what that Wrangler has been for many, many years. Yes, this is first version without a doubt, and they're only gonna get better, but competition makes everything better. So I'm interested to see how Wrangler comes back in this next version and what Ford does in model number two. So if you want more information, keep it right here to either my YouTube channel or wherever you're watching this right now. My name is Michael Garfield, and I am driving off past the sunset in this Ford Bronco. And I tell you what, by the time I get home, probably gonna get stopped about 25 more times. Peace.